Good morning. This is V.R. Karthik, Assistant Professor, Department of Sign Marketing, Department of CSE, Sign Marketing Engineering. Today my topic is Exception Handling. Exception Handling in C++. So my topic is Exception Handling in C++. So before going to discuss about Exception Handling, first of all, what is meant by an exception? An exception is an abnormal termination of a program. An exception is an abnormal termination of a program. What is meant by abnormal termination? So abnormal termination means the sudden termination or immediate termination without giving any warning or without giving any errors. So this is an abnormal termination. So an exception is nothing but whenever we are executing any program, it is terminated without any intimation. So this is called the abnormal termination. The abnormal termination of a program is called exception. So here in exception, we have two types of exceptions. The first one is synchronous exceptions.
Sir, Andy.
The first one is the synchronous exceptions. And the second one is asynchronous exceptions. So these are the two types of exceptions. First one is synchronous exception, second one is asynchronous exception. What is meant by synchronous exception? The synchronous exceptions means the exceptions which are caused due to the internal problem in a program or problem in a logic of the program, that is called synchronous exceptions. So the examples for synchronous exceptions are divided by zero. Divided by zero exception or array out of bounds exception, array out of bounds exception, etc. Whereas the asynchronous exceptions means the asynchronous exceptions are caused due to the problem in the hardware. Whether, for example, if the keyboard is suddenly stuck, it is not working, or some CPU is got stuck, then those type of exceptions are called asynchronous exceptions. So the examples for asynchronous exceptions are, one is the keyboard error, or some mouse error, or any hardware problem, does not depend on the program logic. It simply depends on the hardware problems like keyboard error, mouse error, or any other type of error. So these are two important types of exceptions in C++. One is a synchronous exception and another one is asynchronous exception. Now my question is, what type of exception we can handle? What type of exceptions we can handle in C++. So the question is, what type of exceptions we can handle? Can we handle synchronous exceptions or asynchronous exceptions? So the answer is, we can handle only synchronous type of exceptions. We cannot handle asynchronous type of exceptions. Why? Because C++ can able to handle only synchronous exceptions. Why? Because the synchronous exceptions are dependent on the logic of the program, so we can handle it. Whereas the C++ is unable to handle asynchronous exceptions. Why? Because these are completely dependent on the hardware solutions, hardware problems. So the C++ cannot handle this. So because it is a hardware problem which is beyond the control of the program or beyond the control of the software. So this is the answer for this. So the C++ handles only synchronous exceptions. It is unable to handle asynchronous exceptions. So coming to the next one, how to handle exception in C++. which can be useful while handling any exception in C++. Now coming to what is try, what is throw and what is catch. So for better understanding what this, so I can explain this with an example program. So let us take a small example program. As you know, I was stream. So using space.
Hello.
Name space.
Hello.
Using space, name space.
Hello.
SP. So this is a C++ header. So now I can take main function and now I am declaring two variables here, int a comma b, int a comma b. Two variables declared here. So first I want to enter the value of a. So see out, enter a value and then reading in a value. Then I want to enter the b value. So see out, enter b and see in b. So from here I read two integer values a and b. So now I am using the exception handling. How we can handle these exceptions? So as we already discussed, so divided by zero. For example, let us say a value is 5 and b value is 5, then we don't have any problem. Why? Because when dividing a by b, 5 by 5, so the answer is 1. It is absolutely fine. So there is no problem. In some situations where some a value is some 5, and b value is from 0. Then if you want to find out a by b, then 5 by 0 is equal to infinity. But in programming, it cannot find out an infinity solution. Because in mathematics, we can say that 5 by 0 is equal to infinity. But whereas in programming, it is not possible to find this. So this is called error. This is called error in programming, that error is called divided by 0. Divided by 0. This is a divided by 0 exception. So from this program, what I want to explain is, I want to handle the divided by 0 exception using C++. So first I am making the block try block. Because in C++ exception handling, the first block is try block. The purpose of this try block is, first we have to check. Try means trying. Trying means checking. What we are checking here? Whether the given variables a and b is having any exception or not. So in this example, I am checking whether this is having an exception or not. So initially try, and here I am making, first I want to check the condition. If of here a value and b value, first I entered a value as 10 and b value is 2. Now first I want to check the condition. What is the condition? Whether the denominator is 0 or not. If the denominator is 0, then we can say that it is a divided by 0 exception. If the denominator is other than 0, that means it is not a divided by 0 exception. Further, I want to write a condition here. That is, if of b equal to 0. Here my logic is, numerator is a, denominator is b. I want to check whether the denominator is 0 or not. If the numerator is 0 means we don't have any problem, because it is, does not belong to divided by 0. We want to check only denominator. So denominator is equal to 0, then what we have to do is, we have to throw the exception. So if our b is equal to 0, then throw block, using throw b. What it means, when b is equal to 0, then
hello,
we have to throw the
value. Madam, sollunga sir.
Else.
Na inga video eduthitte irukke sir, your Karthik sir.
See
out. Ah, munjittu. Ah. Ah.
Catch. See out. Division not possible. Division not possible. When when B equal to B. So this is a triangle. So the another important thing is always write the throw block. Here the major blocks are, one is the throw block, the first block is the drive block, and finally we have to write the catch block. But here the important thing is the throw block is always written inside the drive block. Throw block always written inside the drive block. Don't write the throw block outside the drive block, because whenever the condition is met, B equal to 0, whenever the denominator is equal to 0, that means it is an exception. So then immediately we have to throw that exception. So whenever it is throwing the exception B, immediately another block is required to handle this exception. What is that block? That is called the catch block. Finally, the catch block is required to handle the exception. So here I am taking in x here. And see how exception occurred. Exception occurred. So this is the try block, and inside the try block I am writing the throw of B. So now what happens is A value is 10, B value is 2. So whenever A value is 10, B value is 2, first it is checking the condition. B value is what? 2. So 2 is equal to 0. This is true or false? False. This is false. So whenever this condition is true, then only it will go inside the if block. Whenever the condition is true, then only it will throw the exception. But here this condition is false, so it simply comes out of the else block, and it will find out. It is quite out the division, because this is not an exception. So here we don't need to write the throw block statement. We have to find out C is equal to. C is equal to what we have to do? We have to find out A plus B. We have to find out the A plus B. Why? Because whenever this exception is not, this condition is not true, then immediately it goes to the else block and it will find out C is equal to A plus B. Then what it thinks? The output, whenever enter A value is 10 and enter B value is 2, then denominator is not 0. So it simply come to the else block and find out the C value, that is A plus B. Or that is, we are finding the division, so we can use A by B. So equal to A by B, so C value is 5. For example, in another situation, let us say that A value is 10 and B value is 0. Now what happens? It check the condition now. If of B is equal to 0, B value is what? 0. So it checks 0 is equal to 0. True or false? It is true. Whenever denominator is 0, condition is true, then it comes into the if block and it throws the exception. What is the exception now? B. What is B here? 0. So this is an exception. That's why then B, 0 value will be thrown to the catch block. Because when the catch block is executed, means whenever exception is occurred, then only throw block throw the statement. Whenever throw block throws the statement, exception statement, then only catch block will be executed. Then catch block will be here, x value is 0. And this is the case 1. In case 1, when A value 10, B value 2, the C value is 5. But in another case 2, first enter the A value is 10 and enter the B value is 0. Then the output is not, it doesn't give the division value. Instead of it is giving this message, because it is thrown exception. So output is exception occurred. Exception occurred. If you want to write another thing, exception occurred at the